Now we will talk about the conceptual model corresponding to these applications. We will look at the different types of screens needed to develop an application for smart devices, the objects that implement them, and their relationships. Here are the different types of screens needed to develop an application for smart devices. The first one we see is the menu. It essentially contains items that correspond to the main options offered to the user. It can be shown as a tab, as in the case of our application, this is the iPhone default, but we can also show it as a table, which is the Android default, or as a list, which is the iPad default. We'll come back to this later. Here we see a list of elements to work with. This is similar to the concept of working with the data of a transaction. The way to present the information of the list is configurable, and the essential thing is that in this screen, an insert option is included by default to call the detail screen in that mode. Tapping on an element of the list automatically calls the detail screen in display mode. From the detail screen of an element in display mode, it's possible to view the detailed information of the element selected by the user from the list, although it can also be accessed directly. If in this screen you want to enable the edit or CRUD create, read, update, and delete operations, at this point there will also be a layout for addition. Here we see the edit layout that is used when we want to perform the edit, delete, or insert operations. For example, here we see the call of the edit mode. Finally, we have panels that provide all the freedom to design the layout without preset structuring. In this case, the developer must implement the layout and program the behavior from scratch. In this example, we see the screen to view sessions, whose data will be obtained through a data provider. To implement these screens and their functionalities, we have three objects: menu for smart devices, which implements the menu; work with for smart devices, this is an object and a pattern, two in one. Unlike work with for web, it's not an instance file from which objects are created that implement the typical work with element containing a transaction's information. Instead, it's an object that includes those types of sub-objects, the ones that implement the list and detail screens with all their sections or tabs. Generally, this object will be associated with a transaction, but the fact that it's an object that can be created from the object creation dialog gives you the flexibility to create all its screens, list, and detail from scratch, loading information in the desired location. Panel for smart devices. They're similar to web panels. Also, they're similar to any of the list screens or to each section of the detail of work with for smart devices. The difference is that they're created from scratch, so the developer is absolutely free to add and remove whatever he wants, and load the data from the database or anywhere else. Here we explain how the work with for smart devices element encapsulates the list and the detail, and at the latter level, the display screens for general and related information, and the edit screen, CRUD, for general information. To invoke each of the three, list, detail, and view mode, detail and edit mode, the syntax is the one shown, taking as an example the pattern work with for smart devices applied to the speaker transaction. In the case of editing, the invocation always indicates the operation: insert, update, delete. We'll come back to this later. The menu for smart devices object will essentially consist of items that specify the actions that will be offered to the user. Each one of them will correspond to an event where you program what to invoke as a result of choosing the item. When inserting each action, the Select Objects window will automatically open so that we can choose the object we want to invoke as a result of that action. The invocation will be automatically programmed in the events, which, of course, we can modify. There can be many menu for smart devices objects inside the application, all the times you need to use a menu. Unlike web applications, which allow multiple entry points from URLs, smart device applications, which will be installed on the device, have a single entry point. The entry point must be a main object and is usually a menu for smart devices object. This is why the menus for smart devices, by default, are main objects. Although each platform has its standard layout, we can choose that the menu items are shown in table form, which is the default value of Android phones, in tabs, which is the default of iPhones, where the central area appears loaded with the object called by the first item, in our case, the Today panel, or even in list form, the default for tablets. To modify the default behavior, there's a property of the menu for smart devices that allows you to select one of these three values, table, tabs, or list, which is the control property. Starting from the speaker transaction, applying the pattern work with for smart devices to it will cause the creation of an object of this type, which will show a hierarchical structure that implements the list and the detail. The developer will be able to customize it, working directly on their screens, as we can see in the following pages, adding or removing levels, or even removing the list or the detail, or adding to or removing sections from the latter. When applying the pattern to the single level transaction, speaker, we can see that a level appears that corresponds to that level of the transaction, with the mentioned hierarchical structure. The detail consists of several sections, the general one, corresponding to the information of that level of the transaction, and a section for each table in the database containing information directly subordinated, in this case, the sessions in which the speaker takes part. Where is the list screen we see running designed? This is in the Work With List node. And where can we find the screen to view the details of the general information of a speaker? This is in the Section General node of the Detail node in View mode. And how about the screen corresponding to the sessions of that speaker? This is in the Section Session node, corresponding to data of the table subordinated to speaker. Finally, where's the screen for performing CRUD operations, create, update, delete, implemented? The one we accessed, for example, by tapping on the update icon on the view screen. This is also in the Section General node by selecting the edit screen of the lower combo. That is, for the Section General, we have two independent layouts, even if they're initialized with exactly the same attributes, the layout of the view screen and the layout of the edit screen. To implement a panel from scratch, such as that of the sessions lists, we have an object that is very similar to any of the nodes of the work with element. The difference with the work with element applied to a transaction is that while the work with elements are already initialized, the panel will be completely empty. It has no associated logic. In this panel in particular, we can see that the developer has inserted in the layout a grid with variables, which will be loaded in the load event with the results returned by a data provider.